Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to discuss the concept of weighted average costing. We'll start off by going through what the weighted average costing method is. Next, we'll talk about how companies can use this method to value their inventory and cost of goods sold by looking at a specific example. Understanding this concept can help companies manage their resources more effectively and make smarter long-term business decisions. So let's get started. Most manufacturing and merchandising companies spend a significant amount of money on inventory. A company's ability to manage inventory has a major impact on their financial performance. When companies sell their inventory, they generate revenue. However, they also need to record the cost of these goods that are sold. The challenge with inventory is that it can be difficult to keep track of the original cost of each unit that's sold, as a result of things like fluctuating prices. This is where the weighted average costing method can be extremely useful, as it helps companies simplify the accounting process and track inventory value more effectively with less record keeping. Weighted average costing is a valuation method that assists companies in the process of assigning values to their cost of goods sold and inventory. Instead of specifically identifying the amount paid for each piece of inventory that's sold, companies can use this method to calculate an average of the overall value of their inventory. The formula for the weighted average cost method is as follows. Weighted average cost per unit equals cost of goods available for sale divided by units available for sale. Cost of goods available for sale is the value of all of the inventory that the company has ready and available to sell to their customers throughout the period. This is calculated using the formula. Cost of goods available for sale equals beginning inventory value plus the inventory purchases. For example, if a company had $100,000 of inventory at the start of January and purchased another $50,000 of inventory throughout the month, the cost of goods available for sale that month would be $150,000. Units available for sale would be the total number of units that the company has in their inventory that they have ready to sell that period. This is calculated by adding beginning units in inventory and the units purchased during the period. For example, if the company had 100 units in inventory at the beginning of the month and purchased another 50 units during that month, their units available for sale would be 150 units. If we go back to our weighted average cost formula and take the $150,000 cost of goods available for sale and divide it by the 150 units available for sale, this gives us a weighted average cost of $1,000 per unit. This means that even though some of the individual pieces of inventory may have cost more or less than this amount, the average value of all of the inventory works out to $1,000 per unit. Using this method has a number of advantages. It simplifies the accounting process, making it so that companies do not need to apply specific values or other more complex cost flow assumptions, such as first in, first out, or last in, first out. It also allows companies to minimize their record keeping, as they don't have to spend time tracking dates and prices for each inventory purchase throughout the period. It also reduces administrative costs. As a result of not having to keep track of everything, it allows companies to reduce their administrative processes, resulting in more time and cost savings. Now that we understand a little bit more about the weighted average cost method, let's talk about a common misconception. While there's many advantages to using this method, there can also be some disadvantages that not all companies consider. Weighted average costing does not always result in the most accurate financial information, since the average inventory cost may not be in line with the most recent inventory prices. When companies are working with inventory where the cost fluctuates significantly due to market factors such as inflation, their newer inventory may have a significantly higher cost than their older inventory. As a result, in these scenarios, it may be more accurate to use another cost flow assumption method to calculate the value of inventory. When calculating the cost of goods available for sale, it's also a common mistake to forget to include all of the new purchases during that period. In order to calculate the most accurate average of all the inventory that the company has available for sale, it's very important that all inventory purchases throughout the period are factored into the calculation. Let's dive into a more detailed example of how the weighted average costing method works. At the beginning of the year, on January 1st, ABC Company had a beginning inventory of 500 units at a cost of $100 per unit for a total value of $50,000. Throughout the first quarter of the year, the company purchased more inventory at three separate times. On January 25th, they bought 200 units at $110 per unit, giving them a total of $22,000 worth of inventory for that purchase. Fast forward to February 15th, they bought 100 units at $120, and on March 1st, they bought another 100 units at $130. Let's use the formula from earlier to calculate the weighted average cost per unit, which equals the cost of goods available for sale divided by the units available for sale. To calculate the cost of goods available for sale, we take the opening value of $50,000 and add in the total cost that the company spent on each of the three inventory purchases that were made throughout the quarter. We would add the $22,000 plus the $12,000 plus the $13,000, which works out to a total cost of goods available for sale of $97,000. Units available for sale would be the 500 units that we had at the start of the year in opening inventory, and we would add in the number of units purchased for each of the three inventory purchases. We would take the additional 200 units plus the 100 plus the additional 100 units to give us a total of 900 units available to be sold that quarter. As we can see here, the price of inventory fluctuated across the various dates that the company made the inventory purchases. However, instead of tracking the original cost for each piece of inventory that sold, the company can now apply this weighted average cost by taking the $97,000 cost of goods available for sale divided by the 900 units available for sale to get an average cost of $107.78 for each piece of inventory that was sold. For example, if 220 units were sold over this period of time, the company's cost of goods sold would be the 220 units times $107.78 per unit, which would equal $23,712. This is the value of the inventory that would be removed from their inventory balance and be recorded as their cost for the first quarter of that year. And that brings us to the end of this video. Weighted average costing is an extremely effective tool that companies can use to manage their inventory. It gives organizations the ability to effectively value their inventory by simplifying the accounting and reducing the administrative process of the inventory tracking. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.